All right, welcome back from that short break. And of course, you're still watching Aben today, right here on Aben Television, getting into our Hello Aben. And in case you missed our interesting conversation regarding how to deal with smelly people and some of the advice that did come through with Senga, head over to our Facebook page as well as Twitter, Aben Television and Aben TV, respectively, and you'll definitely find that conversation. But this morning, on our letter, this one is writing to us saying that, Hello Aben, do not tell people my name. All right, we definitely did not include it in the letter. But he says that my girlfriend has too many passwords in her phone. Every app has a different password. She does not allow me to touch her phone, yet she's always in mine. What is she hiding? Is she cheating on me?
Most definitely, yes! Yes! Baby boy, they are cheating on you left, right, and center, because I highly doubt she has the passcodes to Bank of Uganda's stolen 90 million.
Yeah.
I highly doubt she's the one who is in charge of the president's different speeches or the State of the Union. Boyfriend, they are cheating on you behind! They are! It's
there
beautiful!
There must be a guy like Willis there that you can't see. You see, I was cool with the whole fact that, you know, she has passwords in
and all of that
and everything.
But
because
then,
it's her phone. It's a password mobile phone.
Exactly.
But then the fact that
she's always
in the guy's phone.
Why are you letting her? First of all, the only way you're going to solve this is by putting as many passwords
in your phone.
So now, when she comes to your phone, she's going to be like, Baby, why is your phone? I'm like, yeah, it's my phone. I decided to put passwords. Can you open yours? Let's do it together on the count of three. Open yours, I open mine. Voila.
That's true.
Then that's going to be a beautiful scenario.
But the question is, why are you worried about someone's phone?
Thank you!
How do you know they have passwords in their phone? Why are you...
Because you're tampering.
Phone? Why are you tampering? You understand?
Let me give you a small walk down.
Why is she always in the guy's phone?
Well, that's how they can call it. Wemba sagara kuunvuma. Techitegeza anti sivuma.
Uchitegera.
Nizanyizo kuanga kuunvuma nyiga ni mvako. Nenga temo alati ngantrandi so vuma. Mvumi dadala. So she may not like him to be in her phone, but she wants to be in.
Let me give you a small.
Now it's for me. I would say as a man, you're very insecure if you're going around to look for someone for
a woman.
That's
true.
But you have to understand that women are emotional people, so they like to be sure and certain.
They would like to know.
You understand?
Let me give you a small synopsis. Let me give you a small scenario. So, I was in this relationship. And you know my phone, I'm an entertainer. You can never control the different types of people that get your phone or what they're going to say to you. So my different DMs would be lit with all types of, you know, messages. My inbox on WhatsApp would be crazy. So one time I noticed it after a while that whenever I'd go to bed and put my phone on charge, the next morning I would find it, probably the page on my phone is not what I left, and I kept quiet. So it went on for a month, 2 months, and I knew that my current boyfriend was actually checking my phone. So one day, I hollered at him, like, real talk. I'm like, dude, whatever you're looking for on that phone, you will find. If you want a heartbreak,
you will find
it. And I told him, growing up, basenga bafed dabali batugambanga. Msajia wakuma weka. Natanko kwa wala, ngatuwa yagala kuyomba na ye. Teka ya mazimu kama bunira. Gamirenga mazokolach.
What is
bullying? Ogenda, you keep quiet. You just keep the water in your mouth.
Okay.
So that you don't argue back. Number two. If you want peace of mind, thou shalt not checketh any man's phone or woman's phone. The phone is one thing that gets every type of message out of context. How I text to Willis is not the same context I use with you. Now, between me and Willis, we could be used to a certain particular way of texting. We could use sexual innuendos. We could use so many other different things. And it won't be that.
I like the fact that you used Willis with the sexual innuendos.
Exactly.
Just saying.
Moving on. So, at the end of the day, when this actually stretched from 2 months, we had the conversation, and he still kept doing it for another 6 months. I was like, so did you finally get your heartbreak? Because that day he came back home sobbing. I'm sitting there with a cup of tea. I'm like,
you had such a cry, baby.
But if you're going to look into a woman's phone, like Tina said, you're going to find what you're looking for. I think if you're unless you're idle and this.
Hey, idle, unemployed. Unemployed.
You don't have time looking into your girlfriend's phone. You should be concentrating on making her happy, on enjoying life together. And like I usually say,
on giving her reasons not to have particular.
You are in a relationship with someone when you are with them.
But when you're not with them?
When you're not with them, be happy on your own.
But Willis,
every day becomes new. Never we say, no,
but what is hurting this guy are two things in this letter. The fact that the girlfriend has very many passwords. And when he decides to, you know, have a look at what is in the chick's phone, she does not
What if she's a spy? She's a
spy. So why is she in the guy's phone?
No, she's a spy.
She's hiding information that would even put him in danger.
And then she's checking his phone just to find out if fellow spies have not bugged his phone.
So is there a possibility that this girlfriend could be cheating on the guy?
I don't think so.
I mean, to each
so what is she hiding? It doesn't make logical sense.
Passwords all over my phone. Mean that I'm cheating.
Apps that are facial recognition, I have some apps that are fingerprint, I have some apps that are a pattern, I have some apps that are, I mean, it depends on the sensitivity
of
the app.
She might be taking pictures of him and her together, and she's putting passwords in the phone, so when she leaves it somewhere, other guys don't get it. She's protecting the relationship.
But at the end of the day,
what best advice should we give this man?
Leave the phone alone.
Your business. Make sure your phone has airtime. Make sure your phone has data.
Do
Make
you?
Sure your phone has, the screen is clean. Why are you minding her phone?
Let her check if she wants to check.
Let
if
her
check
her.
If she finds a heartbreak, that's her own.
But then again,
Who
cares? No, but yeah, at the end of the day, again, this what we're telling him, yes, that is the logical thing to do. But being a human, we are prone to inquisitiveness. You know, curiosity killed the cat. And I know he's not just going to let that go. What we're going to do is get you a friend. Like one kagal she has always been insecure about. Right? Tell this buddy, enchai, njaga umpereze messages or cha. And keep that conversation too. Right? Of you directing her to do that. And then let her send all these nasty messages. Let her send. Then on that day,
they check.
Put the phone there. You'll hear her alone in the bedroom screaming. Now when she comes, you're like, that's the test of your own medicine. Why do you check my phone if you don't want me to check yours? I am very sure if I checked yours, I would be like that. So stop checking my
phone. But if you don't check your mom's phone as a man, why are you checking phone? If you don't check your brothers and sisters' phones, why are you checking?
Do you know how weird it is to check your brother's
phone?
It's not even your brother. How would you check your mom's phone?
Your mom's phone, it's okay. You're going to see you at pasta meetings, But
it's
your brother.
Weird to check your girlfriend's phone.
It is weird.
Imagine the conversation between your girlfriend and their scar.
I think this is.
Imagine a conversation between
the dogs who are having sex behind the kitchen.
And are they looking at them because they're not being paid? Now, here's one thing we need to understand. Has this guy tried to ask for passwords from the girlfriend and the girlfriend has refused?
By the looks of it, he has.
For that reason.
That means he was dumb enough to give the girlfriend his passwords. So go ahead and change. Change your passwords. And just keep quiet. Go change your password. It's true.
No, let me tell you people. This thing right here, this is radioactive. If you want to know the one thing that breaks and makes things, this here right here. Most people will say it's the internet. But it's this. A phone is your worst nightmare. That's why most marriage that's why most marriage counselors tell you when you get home, get the phone, put it on the side. Let that be that. No phones at the dinner table, no phones here, no phones there. Let your phones be yours.
People are evasive of their lives. They don't like to talk about themselves in relationships. Sananga, you have a lot to hide. You have a lot to hide because you haven't opened.
One thing I noticed about Africans, we do not have respect for personal space. When you talk to somebody who is in the first world, personal space is key. Down to a 5-year-old who lives in your house that you built, you have to knock at their door. privacy is a must. Mm. And that is something we shouldn't compromise about.
I want you to hold on to that thought. I cannot know.
What we're going to do right about now, we're going to go in for a very short break. And of course, when we do get back, our studio lines are going to be open. The number to call is right there on your screens right now, 0414-337872. Write it down somewhere. And then when we do get back, we hope you have enough airtime to call us and let us find out a solution for this young man here who is having troubles with the girlfriend's password, who is always in his phone. All that coming up right after this break.